Hey, Ross.
I've completed my project on the topic of why should we security test. Through this project, I've researched why we should security test and looked into the process of security testing, and I've come to the conclusion that yes, we should security test. So, what is a security test? Well, there's many different types of security tests. There's infrastructure security testing, application security testing, mobile application security testing, and web application security testing. Each of these covers a different branch of security testing for different devices. Infrastructure covers devices such as systems, firewalls, and routers, and can go into detail on things such as the configuration, the updates for the system, or anything else to do with them. Application security testing covers kind of what Jamie's just been talking about, making sure that the software is secure for the system. The web application security testing covers websites and anything on the web. A common form of attack for web applications is SQL injection, which can be done fairly easily, but is also fairly easy to prevent. Mobile application security testing covers mobile applications. This can be useful, for instance, if an organization has people using their phones on the company network or using their phones to connect to things on the company network. What are vulnerabilities, threats, and attacks? When a system has a weakness that can be exploited, this is called a vulnerability. They're usually found in the underlying operating system or software on the machine. Threats are people or things that can exploit vulnerabilities to cause harm to a system or application. Attacks are what happens when a vulnerability is used by a threat to gain access to a system. What is the process of security testing? Often a security test will include a penetration test, which usually also includes a vulnerability scan. The vulnerability scan assesses a system for any obvious vulnerabilities in it and can be helpful for the tester to know when they continue with the testing. Before a security test can begin, the tester must have authorization from someone high up in the company to begin the test, because it could cause damage to systems that they don't want to be damaged. There is also probably going to be a scope and boundaries set out for the tester so that they don't break anything that they're not supposed to be touching or anything that's critical. What happens during a security after a security test? Well, after a security test, the tester will write up all their findings in a user-friendly way with words that aren't hard to understand. The recommendations that are written there should be fairly easy to implement and should not be complicated for people such as CEOs or managers to understand when reviewing it. Any questions?
Yep. Two things you mentioned that I'd like you to tell me a wee bit more about if you can. So the first one was penetration testing. So you mentioned it, but you didn't really say what it was.
Right. It's the process where an attacker will use tools or software similar to what a real hacker would use to try and gain access to a system.
Okay, so it's almost simulating
yeah.
a hack.
Yeah.
Is that right? Okay. The other one was quite early on, and it was SQL injection,
yeah.
a type of attack. Mm-hmm. Tell me a wee bit more about that.
It's where on a website with a form that has user entry, they don't do anything to the input before it's put into an SQL query, and it's run on a database. So the user entering into the website can change the query or add bits onto it to do what they want it to do,
rather than what the form
yeah.
query should actually do.
Yeah.
Good answer. Well done.
Cool.